Greetings, I'm Will Whitfield with W3 Productions. If you've seen some of my previous videos, I have discussed how to import a Daz character from Daz Studio 4.10 to Blender 2.79 using either the FBX or Filmbox method or using the Daz Importer from Diffeomorphic. I've been playing around with both methods in 2.8 beta and have received some different results. I talked about it briefly on my website, w3productions.com, but I wanted to talk about it more in depth in this video. I'm going to bring up a bigger version of this picture right here and zoom in a little bit. On the left, we have a character brought into Blender 2.8 using the Filmbox method. On the right, we have the same character brought in using the Daz Importer development version. The Daz Importer gives us pretty much what we would expect coming from Daz Studio. On the left, with the FBX version, we have a slight difference, or major difference depending on your character. FBX now uses the principal shader upon import automatically, which is an improvement, but there are some drawbacks. The metallic and specular values are turned all the way up, giving us this tin or dull shade, color or shaded skin and hair. The clothing looks a little less realistic. The eyes don't come out as brilliantly as you would expect. And the shadows, I think, are a little bit harsher than in the Daz Importer version. Now, I'm going to show you what's going on in Blender 2.8. Before I do that, I wanted to show you that you can get the latest development version of the Daz Importer from diffeomorphic.blogspot.com. If you go down below the second picture, there's a link for the development version, which is known to work in version 2.8. I do have some viewers saying that the latest stable version of 1.3 may also work in Blender 2.8. So here we are in Blender version 2.8. I have already imported the Daz Importer version of the character and the FBX version of the character. I'm going to go through the FBX version first on the right. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the body and move this up. I already have the shader editor already populated here. And this is the general setup you'll see for all the materials for the FBX version. And as you can see, there are, a dozen or so materials. For each version, or for each material, you'll see that the metallic and specular values are turned all the way up. So in order to fix that problem, you have to turn all of these down for all of these materials, which can be time consuming. And this material, I've already turned it down, and in a preview, you can see it's a little more realistic than the other ones. The other problem comes in with any material that requires an alpha channel. And I'm going to scroll up here and click on the hair for the best example, because each hair material requires an alpha channel. And by default, the way it's set up, this principal shader is already connected directly to the material output. In order for the alpha channel to work, I had to add in this mix shader and also a transparent shader. I mixed the transparent with the principal shader using the image texture given as the factorial input. And that has to be done for every material using an alpha channel. For this character, that includes the hair. Also on the body, that includes the eye reflection, adding these two nodes in, and also for the eyelashes. adding these two nodes in. You don't have to do that for the Daz Importer version because it's already done for you upon import. Just as a quick note, upon all the other steps you need to get the Daz Importer working, one of the parts you need to do is go to Edit Preferences and add your zip file using the Install Add-on from File option here. There are also a few differences when you import a Daz character. Clicking on Import Daz File, we have some different material options here in the bottom left. The opaque materials or diffuse materials is pretty much the same, with the two choices being BSDF or Principal Shader. There's an addition of the refractive materials. You have BSDF, Principal. Guess is supposed to be for having a better solution for eyes. And custom is supposed to be a better solution for glass. There's also an option to bring in an environment for the world. So clicking on the hair for the Daz Importer version, we see we already have the mix shader here being fed by the transparent shader and the principal shader, and using this image texture as the factorial input for each material that makes up the hair. Same thing for anything on the body, including the eyes and the eyelashes. And this setup is what gave us the results we see right here. One thing I haven't accomplished yet is getting this to work in the Eevee renderer, because the alpha channel material doesn't work for either character. The eyes come out white and the eyelashes come out as one solid material. But this does work well with the Cycles engine in 2.8. Again, my one hang up of why I don't convert completely over to the Daz Importer is that I have not found a way to bring over the morphs from Daz Studio into the character. I use morphs a lot when I use the lip syncing add-on in Daz Studio. I could save poses and actions in Daz Studio and import them here using the Daz Importer, but that doesn't help with lip syncing. If you found a way to make that work, I'd love to hear from you. There's a lot more to explore in Blender 2.8. Thanks for watching. If you learned anything today, please be sure to like, subscribe, and comment down below. And definitely share with other 3D artists you may know out there. Have a blessed day.